Hi everyone. Today we are going to learn about the 8th max first unit numbers, properties of rational numbers. So the fourth property, identity property. Okay. So now we see that the identity property for addition. Okay. So for any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number 0 such that 0 plus A equal to A equal to A plus 0. Okay. So we take any rational number A, so add 0, so we will get the same rational number A only. So okay, here 0 plus A, here A plus 0. Okay, the order only change. Okay dear students, now we see the example. For example, we take A equal to minus 3/7. Okay, so now we add. So 0 plus minus 3/7 equal to, what is the answer? We add 0. So what is the answer? Minus 3/7 only. Okay. So 0 for no value. Yes or no? Yes. So equal to A plus 0. A plus 0. So the value of A, minus 3/7 plus 0. Okay. So we get minus 3/7 only. Okay. So hence 0 is the additive identity for minus 3/7. So the additive identity for minus 3/7, 0 only. Okay, now we see the identity property for multiplication. Okay, so for any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number 1 such that 1 into A equal to A equal to A into 1. Okay, so we take any rational number A, so multiple by 1. Okay, so we get A only, the rational number only. So here the order change, A into 1. Okay, here 1 into A, here A into 1. So but we get the rational number A only. Okay dear students, let us see the example. Now we take A equal to minus 3/7. Okay, so 1 into minus 3/7 equal to, so we multiply by 1 for any integer. So we will get that same integer, yes or no? Yes, minus 3/7. Okay, so equal to, we change the order, minus 3/7 into 1. Okay, so 1 into minus 3/7 equal to minus 3/7, or minus 3/7 into 1 equal to minus 3/7 only. Okay, so hence the 1 is the multiplicative identity for minus 3/7. Multiplicative identity, yes or no? The multiplicative identity. Okay, so before the additive identity, okay, their addition only. Okay dear students, next we see inverse property. So the inverse property, fifth property, inverse property. Okay, so we see the additive inverse property. Okay, for any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number minus A. Okay, such that A plus minus A equal to minus A plus A equal to 0. Okay, so we take any rational number A and that opposite number, yes or no? So the minus A, here order change, minus A plus A equal to 0 only. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. So the 0 is additive identity. The 0 is additive identity. Okay. So let us see the example. Okay. So now we take A equal to minus 11/23. Any rational number. Okay. That positive or negative, no problem. Okay. So minus A, minus of minus 11/23 equal to minus into minus plus 11/23. Okay. Now we apply A plus minus A. Okay. So the value of A, minus 11/23 plus minus A, 11/23. Okay. So here same denominator, yes or no? Yes. So minus 11 plus 11/23 we get. So the 2 also cancel, 0 only. So 0/23 equal to 0. So A plus minus A equal to 0. Okay, now So the order change. First minus a plus a. Okay, the value of minus a 11 by 23 plus minus a. So the a value minus 11 by 23 plus the value of a 11 by 23. Okay, same denominator. So minus 11 plus 11. So the minus 11 plus 11 cancel. 0 divided by 23 equal to 0. Okay. So minus a plus a equal to 0. So therefore a plus minus a equal to minus a plus a equal to 0 is true. Okay. So here also 0 and here also 0 only. Okay. So next we see multiplicative inverse property. Multiplicative inverse property. For any rational number b. Okay. Here we take the rational number b. So there is a unique rational number 1 by b. 1 by b. Such that. So b into 1 by b equal to 1 by b into b equal to 1. Okay. So here we take any rational number b. So b into 1 divided by b. B into 1 divided by b. And 1 by b into b equal to, we get the value 1 only. We get the answer 1 only. Okay. Okay. Here the 1 is the multiplicative identity. Okay. Let us see the example. B equal to minus 17 by 29. We take the rational number b equal to minus 17 by 29. So we find 1 by b. So 1 by b. Okay, so 1 divided by b minus 17 divided by 29. Okay, so we get the 29 upside come. Yes or no? 29 divided by minus 17. So we can write minus 29 divided by 17. The minus also the numerator will come. Okay, minus 29 divided by 17. Okay, so we find b into 1 by b. So the value of b minus 17 divided by 29 into 1 by b. 1 by b minus 29 divided by 17. Okay. So the 29, 29 cancel. 17 also cancel. Okay. So minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. Okay. Okay. So we find 1 by b into b equal to. So the value of 1 by b minus 29 divided by 17. Into the value of b, we apply the value of b minus 17 divided by 29. So here 17, 17 cancel, 29, 29 also cancel. So here minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. Okay. So therefore, so we get b into 1 by b equal to 1 by b into b equal to the value 1 only. So that is true. Okay. So the 1 is the multiplicative identity. The 1 is the multiplicative identity. Okay dear students, today we saw about the fourth property, identity property and the inverse property for addition and multiplication. Okay. So the remaining we will see the next video. Thank you.